giving you a vocational leg up on everyone else. Here's our career Sherpa, Julie Bauke.
Sloan here, 700 WLW. It is that time of year. We're going to do a little Mr. Do and Mr. Don't. Mr. Do and Mr. Don't's guide to office gifts and parties, because it's that time of the year. What do you get the boss? Do you get a coworker? Do you get the receptionist something? What about your cubicle mate, their partner, or your work wife, your work hubby? And then what happens when you go to the parties? And Julie Bauke from the Bauke Group, Cincinnati's premier job coach at Bauke, the Bauke, B-A-U-K-E, BaukeGroup.com. Julie, good morning. How are you?
I'm great. I think the most important question here is what to get your career Sherpa for Christmas.
Madonna tickets.
Exactly. Thank you.
How about that? You went to Madonna last night in Philly?
In Philly, yeah.
How was that? How was that, by the way?
It was really good, man. She's 60, and she can still move. She can still rock it out. I think she probably has to have her whole body iced the next day. But
I think so.
You know, sort of like in the category of like Mick Jagger and those older folks.
Yeah.
You still got it. You can still get it and show it on stage if you want to.
All right.
Just
well,
like you do every day, Sloan.
Oh, my God. Yes, I'm dancing around
like
a fool.
You're a giver.
Like a fool. I am a giver.
You are.
Let's get to the Christmas stuff because it's that time of year and people go, all right, well, do I get something for my boss? Should you get something for your boss?
Generally speaking, it's very dangerous. Be careful. What is more safe is a group gift. Because there's just so many ways to go and do something inappropriate. And so a group gift is always safer. So let's say you work in an office and there's 10 of you and there's one boss. You know, it's easier to everybody come together and maybe get him or her something that you know they like. Maybe like a membership to a coffee of the month club or something like that because you know they like coffee. But the danger is if everybody's getting an individual gift is that, you know, one person's going to be that suck up who buys, you know, something wildly outrageous, or you could also get something inappropriate and you don't even know it. And so safety in numbers, I guess, when it comes to giving for the boss.
I love doing that and getting a gift and then putting my coworker who I don't like's name on it.
Yeah.
Go down to Hustler Hollywood and you get him something and then you put like Jack Crumley's name on it. It's fantastic.
Yes. I think you just sparked an idea and lots of people across the tri-state just now.
It's the best bit ever. I love doing that. I love doing that.
Oh, my God.
Get somebody else in trouble. It's like, wow, Jack, geez, really? I mean, come on, man. It's a little edible panties. Really? What the hell's wrong with you?
Well, I think would be even worse if, you know, if they're like, thank you, that's exactly what I wanted.
Oh,
you've got that visual in your mind forever. Of
right,
your boss
right. It's like, oh,
underwear.
That's a little bit weird, too. So, okay, that makes sense. You go in, if you're going to get your boss, get something together, get them the Jelly of the Month Club, Clark. That's a gift that keeps on giving all year long.
You know they like, but it's not overly personal.
Right. Jack Crumley, and he's just giving me the look like, if that happens, you're busted. Yeah, because, you know, what do you get them? The cup with the M&Ms in it and a ribbon on it or something like that? Yeah, it's a horrible gift.
You know, I mean, what is it you know they like? I mean, pay attention. I think that's true with gift giving to anybody in your life. Pay attention to what they like. But remember, as I always say, as I call this my annual buzzkill segment, you know, it still works.
Annual?
Annual holiday buzzkill segment.
Good, awesome.
I'm a buzzkill.
Take the fun off.
Yeah.
What about coworkers? That's kind of interesting because then, you know, if you get your coworker something and they didn't get you something, there's that. But there's also elements of jealousy and territorial stuff here. You got to be careful of that too, right?
Yeah. So I think it's always a good idea to have that conversation in advance. So let's say you're new in the office, and you could say to somebody, what do people do for the holidays around here? And you can find out kind of what the culture is. And so let's say you've got a BFF at work.
Right.
And you want to get them something and vice versa. Do the exchange outside of the office. Don't, sort of like inviting every kid every other kid in your child's kindergarten class to a party except one or two.
Right.
You know, think about if you've got some best friends at work and you guys decide to do something among the three of you, do it outside of the office. You know, don't make it so obvious. So just think again. You got to come back and work with these people next week.
Yeah, absolutely. And the other thing is, if you do it in the office and those are the people around, they're going to kind of feel left out because they thought they were part of your little club. You know.
Right. Yes. That's why you just want to be careful, and don't overdo it.
Right.
And You know, yeah. I mean, it's getting the boss a bottle of wine or getting a coworker a bottle of wine, and you don't know that they don't drink. They're in AA. You know, whatever it is, you don't. You have to use some thought if you're going to do it.
All right. If people who work for you, what about a supervisor getting his department, you know, like a bottle of wine each or something like that? Is that a good idea?
You know, that's I think you have to be really careful with alcohol. Yeah. Unless you really know your team well, you know that they talk about loving wine. Again, it's the thoughtfulness. It's more appropriate for a supervisor to buy gifts for his or her team than it is the other way around.
Right.
Because, if you're buying the boss a gift, it can be seen as sucking up, favoritism, et cetera, et cetera.
Of course it is. Absolutely. What other way would you take that?
Yeah, I mean, getting them like an expensive gift is, maybe that's just your gift-giving style. You love to give nice personalized gifts, but you have to stop and think, when it's work-related, how might that be seen by your coworkers? When in doubt, you know, have a conversation and maybe do something where it's an office lunch or get everybody a plant or, you know, something that is, not going to potentially offend. And I know it's hard to do, but that's why I think you got to talk about it in advance so that, you know, you're not Santa Claus showing up, on December 20th with a sack full of gifts and everybody's looking at you like, oh, crap, you know, I didn't get you anything. So I think setting those expectations up front is better. And if someone gets you something and you don't get them something, don't start looking through your desk drawers and give them a pack of pencils. And I think you simply say thank you, write a nice thank you note. And, you know, duly noted for next year. And, you know, don't spaz out over it.
Right, right. And I think the other thing, too, is, you know, you can go a little over the top. For example, you know, if you really like that cute receptionist that you see a couple, you know, taking her on a trip for two to sandals is probably, it's probably frowned upon.
Yes, I would say that is firmly in the no category.
Julie Bauke, what about, let's switch this, going from Mr. Do, Mr. Don't to the office Christmas party. And I always love the stories,
Lord,
because I've been to some before where I've seen some dumpster fires. It's been fantastic. Have you? What's the worst thing you've seen at a corporate party or heard of at a corporate party?
Just.
Come on, give me a case study. I'll give you mine while you're thinking. Ready for this one?
Okay.
All right.
Go ahead.
So this was, I forget when it was a while ago, but radio station Christmas party and, of course, open bar. And it's never the, I mean, I shouldn't say never, but anyway, it was a part-time DJ's significant other that had way too much free gin and decided it'd be a good time to tell the boss that her boyfriend was more talented than anybody else on that radio station.
Oh, wow.
And how he deserved to be full-time, and he doesn't know what he was doing.
Oh.
Awesome.
Okay, so first of all,
that was the best. I don't know if they're still together or not, but it was great.
Yes, unlimited. So how did this part-time weekend DJ react?
I don't remember, but I remember laughing because I heard the story secondhand, and I had to go to my boss.
Oh, my God.
I heard this person was the best. And then when the guy came to work, I guess he was, because he worked in a different department I never saw him, but the guy was getting crucified. It was awesome.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So first of all, you know, it unlimited free drinks is not a good idea for a lot of reasons, including...
What? When is it never a bad idea? When is it never a bad idea for unlimited free drinks? What world do you live in, Bauke?
I can't think of a time.
Never think of a time where free unlimited alcohol is bad.
No, I mean when it's good. I can't think of a time when it's...
I'll give you one example. Right before surgery. But that's the only time I can think that that's a bad thing.
Yeah. Are you talking about for the surgeon or for the patient?
Yes.
Yeah. So if you're an employer... Don't do. So I heard of an office party in Cincinnati where there was cocaine being done in a room off to the side.
Really?
And you know, people showing up drunk. They do some pre-gaming. Where they show up at the office holiday party.
The magic does, man.
Yeah, and what's your drinking personality? So when you've had a couple to drink, are you one of those
to
start telling everybody what you think of them? Or do you just get,
no.
I love you, man? You know, do you just get fun? Do you start grabbing everything in sight, grabbing everybody in sight? Do you hang out under the mistletoe hoping for takers? You've got, first of all, give yourself a party buddy. Somebody who is going to watch you and tell you when you've had enough. I mean, I've done that with people before. It's like, you maybe lay off. You know, you got to see these people again tomorrow.
Yeah, I don't disagree with you. I mean, I've seen that too. The mistletoe thing is, you know, somebody's always clever bringing mistletoe. That year that Brian Combs brought a mistletoe belt buckle, it was horrible.
Oh, man.
Awful.
That's a visual. That's a visual.
Yeah, it is. The whole thing of going and just drinking too much. But there's the problem is, like, if I'm drinking or even drink too much, I don't think you can really tell all that much. I'm maybe a little happier than I normally am, but I'm not grabby or fighty or any of that stuff. I just, I'm fine.
But don't you know people who are? But don't you know people who
Of course I do.
Have to watch them? Yeah.
So why, I don't understand why the rest of us have to pay the price for their bad behavior. Why do I have to be limited in what I can drink? I can handle it. The other person, we got to lower the bar because one jerk is screwing it up for everybody. I hate that.
Well, and that's true. I mean, but that's true. It's true in life. So maybe have a lunch instead of a dinner, instead of a happy hour, instead of a party. I mean, as we've talked about in the past too, I mean, we see our coworkers so much. Do you really want to spend another night with them, another evening with them? Sometimes you do, sometimes you don't. Mm. But if you have an office party, you probably ought to show up for at least a short period of time, have one drink, and then leave.
Gotcha.
I mean, nothing good happens. The longer the night goes on, the less likely something good is going to happen. So, you know, just be conscious as you go in. Don't look at it as an opportunity to, to let loose. This is should not be the highlight of your holiday season. But
so, Julie, you have a worse holiday Christmas party story, office Christmas party story, than Brian Combs' mistletoe belt buckle.
I do not. I do not have anything worse than that. But I've heard plenty of kind of grabbing, kissing, coworkers making out, disappearing into the parking lot to make out in the middle of a holiday dinner, mm-hmm. and when their spouses are actually sitting at the table.
Right.
I know that happened at a major Cincinnati employer.
Yep.
That the husband came out looking for the wife, and she was making out with one of her coworkers in the parking lot. Both were summarily fired. Check yourself.
Wait a minute! They got fired for that?
Yeah,
that doesn't seem to be an impeachable offense since it technically did not happen on company property if they were outside.
Well, but it was a company event.
Oh, I see. Well, they weren't at the event. They had left the event.
They were in the parking lot of the event.
I can make a case here. Yeah, boy, that had to be awkward.
That's just
bad.
That's
bad form right there.
Freaking to handle, right?
Yeah, right, exactly. Hey, Julie, as far as not attending, because, the policy is I have my own friends after 5 o'clock. What is it? Should you go make an appearance? I mean, what if you just simply don't care about your coworkers or the company you work for? It's just a job. And you're like, I'd rather buy my own drinks than this forced fun. What is the boss? How does an employer look at a situation like that?
It really depends on the employer. I mean, in some places, if this is really a big deal and the expectation, you get the message very clearly that the expectation is everybody's going to be there, then you should go. But for a short period of time, make some other plans. Right. You know, go for an hour, and then, this is such a busy time of year. I think it's easy to say, I've got a couple other events to attend that I can't miss. My spouse has an event, and we've got to stop by her event as well.
Yeah.
And so you go, you shake hands, you wish everybody well. Maybe you have one drink, maybe you have a club soda, and then you get out of there. You don't want to be the person talked about the next day at the office for your inappropriate behavior, just like your former coworker.
If
was.
You know you can't Even handle not. Yourself, then just don't get, tell the boss. Hey, listen, I get out of control. I'll take my shirt off. I love to run around naked at these things. Is it okay if I don't show up?
It's okay if you don't show up because that's really a gift
great.
To everybody.
What a great! I mean, that'd be awesome. What a like a rock star. I was like, yeah. Because would you score points with the boss with that? Because he's like, wow, what a stand up guy. He likes to take his shirt off, and he's not going to do that because. He's not going to come to the party. What a stand-up guy. Is the boss looking like, wow, this guy's a wacko?
I hope the boss looks at him like he's a wacko. my gosh. But I hear stories every day about crazy things that happen at work. And we really shouldn't be surprised because work is just a slice of our overall lives. And crazy things happen in people's lives every day. So, but just the poor judgment shown at work by people in charge, people who want to know better.
It never
ceases to surprise.
God, I love those stories. I really do. It's just entertaining. I'm never one of those stories, but it's just entertaining. Could we do a year-end show where you just talk about all the bad stuff you've seen in the workplace? Could we, like, the worst of 2019?
Year-end review.
Would you? I mean, I don't know. Are you like a priest with these people when you job coach them? They're not allowed to, you're not allowed to tell the stories anonymously, or?
Well, no. I mean, because what drives people to look for another job, three times out of four, is a bad boss, in my experience, or a bad culture that is allowed to continue because of poor leadership. That's about 75% of why people leave organizations, in my experience. But you think, wait, what did they say? What did they do? It doesn't seem to be getting any better. We have a lot more awareness, but it doesn't seem to be sinking in. The people who need to make the changes don't think it applies to them.
So what, here's another way to look at this.
Do a year in review.
Okay. Let's put that on the agenda for the next couple of weeks. What about Julie Bauke, our career Sherpa this morning on 700 WLW? We're talking about how to act at Christmas parties and also the gift-giving etiquette. If you missed that, you want to check this segment out on the podcast, too. If you're, you know, do you get something for the boss or not? If you're the boss, do you buy something for your people or not? Who do you get? Who don't you get? How do you handle it? It's all useful stuff. The other thing, too, is what about companies that, you know, hey, they're making a profit or whatever and do absolutely nothing during the holidays? Is that necessarily a bad thing? Because there's two ways to look at it. People are like, oh, my God, more forced fun. I don't want to go to the office party and hang out with people I see. The other element is, okay, we won't do anything, and then you look like a cheapskate.
Yeah, I mean, I think part of you have to look at what the culture is. If it's the type of culture where, as an employee, do you feel taken advantage of? Is it the type of culture where they show their appreciation in decent pay, in treating you well throughout the year? Maybe the holidays isn't that big of a deal. You know, sort of like, you know, Mother's Day or Valentine's Day. You know, I mean, Valentine's Day. You know, do you just want the flowers and the love on February 14th?
Right.
Or does your spouse treat you well all year long? I think it's part of that is cultural. But I think for a lot of people, it is forced fun. You know, maybe you let everybody leave a couple hours early. Maybe you give everybody a gift card, or you bring a coffee cart in with fancy coffees for everybody. Mm. You know, doing something that it doesn't have to cost a lot. I think it's just the acknowledgement that, hey, we're ending one year and beginning to start another one. Let's go out on a high note.
Right.
But it doesn't have to be crazy.
Yeah, all right.
But I think just even a small acknowledgement is truly appreciated.
You know, what about like a potluck? And they say, okay, we're going to have a party potluck and the company buys, we'll pay for the ice.
I know. I am not a fan of potluck.
We'll get you the me neither.
Yeah. Because, I mean, people's cats walk across the countertop.
And your tastes are different than mine.
It's your cats roll.
I'm a pretty good cut. Yeah, I don't know what that is. I don't know what you got in it. It's
right, you
know,
yeah.
Yeah, if you can't do it right, don't do it at all is what I say.
Yeah, I'm not a fan.
All right, Julie Bauke, you want to pimp that podcast? You're too busy hanging with Madonna.
Well, what is today? Today is Wednesday. So Monday, we've got Catherine Nero. We've got her episode released. And she's going to talk about being fired. And what she learned from being fired. So look for that to drop, as the kids say, on Monday at the Evolved Career.
At the Evolved Career. That's the podcast. Julie Bauke, our career Sherpa at thebaukegroup.com. Thanks again. Have a lovely time there in Philly, and safe trip back. We'll talk next week.
Okay. See you. Bye.